Hi everyone, Christina here. Welcome to another card video at my YouTube channel and blog. Today I'm going to start out with a bunch of watercoloring using these Mijello Mission Gold watercolors. And because I'm just painting a bunch, I'm going to turn on some music and I'll catch you when I'm finished. After painting all of the flowers and leaves, I cut down my watercolor paper to be a little bit smaller than my card front. And now I'm taking some VersaMark ink and rubbing along all the edges and then dipping the edges into some gold embossing powder. This is Gilded embossing powder from Brutus Monroe, and it's the perfect gold detail for the outer edge of this entire watercolor area. In order to melt the embossing powder, I'm using a heat tool and just kind of running that along the edge and making sure that everything is melted. I don't want any powder kind of hanging around on the surface of this. I want to make sure everything is melted and smooth and ready to move on with the rest of my card. So I'm going to be using a couple dies from Neat and Tangled. This is part of a fundraising project that Daniel, the owner of Neat and Tangled, is putting together to benefit a foundation that is near and dear to her heart. Please check out the details at my blog post. It's a great organization, and I hope you guys will look into it. And this is one of the dies that there's a stamp set and some dies that are kind of part of this fundraising effort. And it's such a cute, encouraging stamp set and die set. And I wanted to use it in today's card. So I die cut the words and also the outer piece. And now I'm taking all of the words and I've temporarily adhered them to some white cardstock so that I can kind of use those as handles while I do more heat embossing. I'm pressing the letters into my VersaMark pad so that they're nice and sticky. And then I'm just going to dunk those into some embossing powder. You could, of course, sprinkle the embossing powder on like you would traditionally, but since I had it kind of as a smaller piece, it was just as easy to dunk that in the powder. I then removed the letters from that temporary paper that I adhered them to, and then used some Ranger Multimedia Matte Adhesive and some tweezers to adhere these onto that background die cut piece. I just put those on, and this is the same gold that is on the edge of the watercolor area, so it's really going to emphasize those different gold details. Then put some foam adhesive on the back of my watercolor piece and put it onto a white card base. This card base is made out of some Nina Classic Crest Solar White 110-pound cardstock, and I just scored that at 5.5 to create a top folding card. Then put some foam adhesive behind the greeting, the celebrate you, and I'll press that down. The last thing I wanted to do was add a little bit of sparkle to this, some iridescence. So I'm using some crystal sequins from Doris. I'm using the 8mm and the 5mm. These are my by far favorite sequins. I use them all the time. If you've been a viewer of my videos or my cards at my blog, you guys know this is my absolute favorite color of sequins. I use it on almost everything. So that's the card for today. Once again, check out that fundraising info over at my blog. I'll have links to even more info that Daniel shared with me. And thank you so much for joining me today. I will see you guys in another card video very, very soon.